Let's do some mathematical modeling where we are finding the equations of lines. So first of all, there are two things that we want to be aware of. The first thing is which quantities are being related. So which quantities in the word problem you're talking about are being related to each other? That's the first question we're going to ask ourselves. And the second one is which depends upon which. So to illustrate that, let me go ahead and graph just put in a little coordinate system here. And if this is x and this is y, now whatever's on the vertical axis, that's called the dependent variable. And whatever's on the horizontal axis is called the independent variable. And the way we think about that is that whatever is here on the vertical axis, that depends upon whatever is on the horizontal axis, okay? So these are our two questions. Which quantities are being related and what depends upon what? Okay, let's go ahead and think about how we can apply this to an application. Okay, so let's say that we're looking through some ads and we find something for sale. I'm selling my awesome surfboard for $100. I've had it for 2 years, and I bought it for $500 from someone who kept it in pristine condition for 3 years after buying it new. Stoked for you. Call Mike, 555-5557. Okay, so we're thinking about buying a surfboard, and we want to, in this problem, we're going to find what's called the straight line depreciation equation. So basically, we're looking for the equation of a line, and we're being told that there's depreciation. That makes sense, right? Because the value of the surfboard is dropping as time goes on. So the first thing we're asking ourselves is, what are the two things being related? Well, clearly we have value, and we're going to denote value with a V. And value, of course, is going to be measured in dollars. But there's also time. And time is going to be measured or represented with a T, and that's in years. So these are the two things that are being related. And the question is, how are they related? What depends upon what? Does value of the surfboard depend upon time? Or does time depend upon the value of the surfboard? Well, of course, time, you know, the unifier of everything in the universe doesn't depend upon the value of Mike's surfboard. Thank goodness. The value of Mike's surfboard depends upon time, okay? So that means the value of the surfboard, V, is going to be on the vertical axis, and time is going to be on the horizontal axis. So it's going to look like this. Okay, so value of the board is going to go on the vertical axis, and time is going to go on the horizontal axis. Now, we're looking for the equation of a line, right? So let's write that as y equals m times x plus b. This is the slope-intercept form of a line, as we know. Now, instead of y, right, we're going to use v because v is on the vertical axis. So v is m times not x, but t, because that's on the horizontal axis, plus b. So what we have to do is we have to find m and we have to find b, the y-intercept. Now, what we have to do is, whenever you find the equation of a line, you need two quantities. You need the slope of the line, and you need a point on the line. So to begin getting these two quantities, we want to think about just the problem to begin with. Now, there's a lot of information here. To get slope, what we're going to be looking for are two points. And to find two points, of course, you know that points have coordinates, right? They have we've been calling this an x coordinate and a y coordinate. Now, it's not x and y in this problem. It's what? Well, it's t and v. And that's a very important thing to realize, that as soon as you decide what's independent and what's dependent, that the independent quantities go first and the dependent quantities go second. And that's why you think about this relationship, so that now you can begin thinking about ordered pairs and which quantity goes where. So let's reread this problem here. Mike selling his board for $100. Now, how old is this board? Well, he's had it for 2 years, but he bought it from somebody who had the board for 3 years after buying it new. Okay, that means the board is 5 years old, right? Mike's had it for 2 years, but he bought the board when it was 3 years old. So that means the time now is five, right? So the board is 5 years old, and what's its value now? Well, it's what Mike is selling it for, which is $100. So when the time is five, that is 5 years from, you know, when the time is zero, the board is new. Five means the board is 5 years old. The board is worth $100. Notice how I don't put dollar signs here. I'm just keeping track of the numbers. What else do we know? Well, Mike bought it. He's had it for 2 years, but he bought the board when it was 3 years old. That is, when the board was 3 years old, what was it worth? Well, Mike paid $500 for it. Okay, so we have 2 points, 5, 100, 3, 500. And that's because when the board was 3 years old, it was worth $500. But now that it's 5 years old, it's worth $100. So we can find the slope giving these 2 points, right? So the M is going to be, let's see, 500 take away 100 divided by, well, 3 take away 5. And it's going to be 400 divided by negative 2, and that is negative 200. Now, first of all, what's the meaning of negative 200? That's the same thing as negative 200 over 1, which means that every time the time increases by 1 year, the board does what? It drops in value by $200. So that's why this is called a depreciation equation, because the value is depreciating, the slope is negative. So we have our slope, it's negative 200. So V is equal to negative 200 times T plus the y-intercept. Now, the y-intercept, of course, has an x-coordinate, or in this case, a t-coordinate of 0. Neither of these points are the y-intercept, but you can get the B by plugging in the coordinates of one of these points. So for example, if I pick the first point, well, V is 100 when T is 5. So I'm going to replace the V with 100, and I'm going to replace the T with 5. So negative 200 times 5, right, plus B. So I get 100 is equal to negative 1,000 plus B. And that, if I add 1,000 to both sides, I find that I get 1,000 plus 100. That is, I get 1,100 is equal to B. So that means my equation, right? I already found my M. My equation is this. The value of the board is equal to negative 200 times T plus B, which is 1,100. Okay? And this would be my answer. Now, there are a couple of interesting things about this problem. And the first thing is that the y-intercept is, in this case, it's 1,100. And what does that mean? Well, that means when the time was zero, the board was worth $1,100. Okay, so somebody bought it for $1,100. And the board has been dropping in value, right? So it's dropping in value. Now, according to this graph, it looks like there's going to be some time when the board has no value. So how would you find that? How would you find the time when the board has no value? To do that, you could set the value equal to zero. So you could ask yourself, when is the value equal to zero? Okay, and so if you do that, you're going to be solving the equation. Zero is equal to negative 200 times T plus $1,100. Now, when you get that, of course, that's going to give you some time, and that, of course, is your t-intercept. So this is how you generally find the equation of lines in modeling. You have to ask yourself, what are the quantities you're looking for? And which one is the dependent variable? And which one is the independent variable? And then try to write the information, try to represent that information as ordered pairs that you can then work with to find the slope and your y-intercept. Okay, until next time.